And the birth of Brisbane owes a huge debt to a pioneering family with a dark past. It's a ripper yarn of a murderous madman whose money still funds our medical school.
A poor but ambitious Irish migrant, Patrick Mayne arrived in Brisbane in 1844.
He was described on the ship's manifesto as being a farm labourer.
But he was much more than that. Today, tour groups can traverse the Mayne's family legacy to the city.
I understand from modern psychiatrists that he was a schizophrenic.
His tale of murder, cruelty and ultimately great philanthropy is told in Rosemond Seaman's book, The Mayne Inheritance. Opportunity knocked for Patrick Mayne at the bar of a Kangaroo Point swill house when he met a drunk flush with £300. He didn't hesitate to put his slaughterman skills to lethal use.
The medical report on the victim noted that the body had been dissected much like an animal dressed for sale. At that stage, no one connected Patrick Mayne to the murder, despite his skill as a butcher.
The grisly crime complete when someone else was convicted for the crime.
19 days later, William Fyfe was hung for the murder of Robert Cox. And that was the end of that.
Safe from the gallows with blood money in his pocket, Patrick Mayne launched a Brisbane dynasty with a dark side.
He had bought a property in Queen Street. He was able to buy stock. He was able to buy a cart. He was able to buy a horse.
And a whip he used on people he didn't like.
He thought it was a game, really, and that he might get convicted and fined.
But for all his wealth and position, he died young, age 41. His youngest son, James, took the tarnish from the Mayne name. He gave gifts of huge lead-light windows to St Stephen's Church.
And the central figure you can see is the Mary rising into heaven.
The Brisbane Arcade is on the site of Patrick's first home and butcher shop.
Most of the woodwork and the panelling is original, and the floor is original as well.
The annual shop rents of more than $1 million still funds research at the Mayne Medical School at Hurston. James Mayne donated all the land for University of Queensland and paid for the ornate building work. Despite his enormous generosity, his name is missing on the university foundation stone.
The powers that be at that time didn't want the son of a criminal mentioned anywhere, although he was giving lots of the money. He was giving the land. They didn't want him named.
This bronzed tribute to James, a much later add-on. Today, there are no Maynes left, recognising what they called the madness of their father. The children never married. The family home, Moorlands, adjoining Wesley Hospital, is also a monument to Patrick. The winged heart on the ornate staircase, an appeal to God to forgive the sins of the past. Tim Collins, 10 News.